The right to make your voices heard will always be protected here in Orange County. The overwhelming majority of the people taking to the streets are doing it peacefully and with respect. It's not the bottles that are thrown or the fires that are set that will encourage people to listen to your hurt or your anger or your calls for change. I have watched many police officers come face to face with protesters, and when everybody remains calm, truly incredible things can happen. People in that situation see each other for who they are. We are all human beings in that particular circumstance. And as humans, we all want peace. We all want equality. You have the absolute right to protest. And as district attorney, I will do everything I can to enforce your right. But when it crosses the line over into criminality, that will not be tolerated by the Orange County District Attorney's Office. I was a police officer with the City of Los Angeles, and I was in the riots in 1992. And I watched the city burn. I can tell you from that experience that looting and rioting is not about justice. It's about opportunists who are corrupting the cause in order to steal. We have robbery crews that are out looking to rob while the police are in other parts of the city. They're lookouts trying to evade the police. I am literally sick to my stomach. My father was a small business owner, and I know what it means to struggle to run a business. These businesses have been closed for months. They thought finally they were going to be able to reopen and get back on their feet. They've invested their life savings. And then thieves and looters and opportunists have now taken this pandemic and extended the misery for business owners. People are watching their dreams, their livelihood shattered, just like all the broken glass and all the twisted metal in these unfortunate storefronts. Let me make something really clear. This outrageous, offensive behavior does absolutely nothing to honor the memory of George Floyd. In fact, it desecrates his memory, and it takes the attention off the social change that we must all work together to achieve. Look what else it does. It puts our first responders in harm's way. Firefighters, police officers, bystanders, journalists have been injured in many of these melees. And most importantly, it jeopardizes you as a lawful protester who have an absolute right to peacefully protest. This is not the Orange County we want. So in order to clear the streets of the bad actors, I am asking all the police chiefs and the Orange County Sheriff to submit their arrests as soon as possible, because we will review these cases and we will determine if we can prove our cases beyond a reasonable doubt. And if we can, we're going to file those cases. And we're going to send a message that if you engage in that conduct, there are real consequences to you and your life. And as your district attorney, I am doing everything I can to clean up our streets, to ensure that lawful and peaceful protests can go on in our county. We are in this together, and I understand fully that you are there doing everything you can to make societal change. And I support that. I want change too. And it is overdue, and you are being heard. And you need to know that from your Orange County District Attorney. But we have to do it correctly. If you really want your voice to be heard, then listen to Martin Luther King. He founded the Center for Nonviolent Social Change in Atlanta, Georgia. And I've been there. And I went there to understand that you can make more change through nonviolent action than you can from looting, rioting, and hurting other people. God bless our county, and God bless your right to get justice for George Floyd. God bless you, God bless our county, and God bless America.